This episode of D News is brought to you by Harry's. When you hear the word detox or cleanse, do you just get irrationally angry? Well, come on, get happy. Let's break this down like the digestive system. Hello everyone, thank you for watching D News today. I'm Trace. Detoxes tell us that our diet is filled with toxins and chemicals that need to be cleaned out. Their solution is to eat raw things or only drink juice for a long time or whatever. Detoxing is a huge industry that has been completely debunked by medical science, but that really doesn't stop us from doing it. If you're a drug addict, medical science can help you clear your system with a detox, but if not, buying dime store online direct-to-consumer health fad detox stuff is not gonna do anything helpful. Pills and potions to improve the body have been sold for centuries, and every time science looks into them, it's pretty obvious that they're selling snake oil. Just go do a Google search. You won't find a single website that doesn't have like three words like healthgreenthing.org in it. The human body is an incredible thing. It can take any number of edible, drinkable, and breathable things, which are actually low-level poisons, and then process them. You're probably thinking like sugar, alcohol, fast food, but oxygen, salt, and water are all poisons. In a high enough quantity, each of those things can kill. It's all in the dosage, everything in moderation. You know, great way to look at it. For example, alcohol got its moniker as a poison from the Women's Christian Temperance Union, the Anti-Saloon League, and the KKK, because they wanted people to stop consuming alcohol. Sure, in massive quantities, alcohol will poison us, but so will salt or oxygen. Plus, popular detox foods like tomatoes or broccoli contain cyanide, and drinking nothing but fructose, which is the sugar which makes fruit juice all sweet, that doesn't go over well in the human body. In reality, the human body comes with structures designed to specifically clean and filter the blood and digestive systems, the liver and the kidneys. They do a great job at keeping us clean on the inside, and when we consume anything, the kidneys and liver filter out actual toxins and send them out of the body as waste. That's it. That's all you gotta do. A detox diet doesn't actually help the kidneys do their job any better. According to The Guardian and Harvard Medical School, detox kits are often designed to make you feel like you're getting something for your money, even if you're actually not. For example, there are no little bits of poop stuck in your colon turning into plaque and pumping toxins into your body. They don't need to be cleansed. But colon cleansing tablets have a polymerizing agent that make your poop stick together into a giant piece, so then you can admire it and feel accomplished when you actually get it out of your body. That actually sounds pretty awesome. I kinda wanna try it. But it doesn't make you any healthier. Even though the detoxing itself isn't doing anything helpful, the act often does have people reporting that they feel healthier or that they have more energy. Some have weight loss. Why is that? All of these things are possible, but some might be a placebo effect. In the end, it could also be down to the highly restrictive forms of many of these diets. Intermittent fasting has shown some benefits, and if you're restricting nutrients, you're essentially fasting. During a fast, your metabolism drops, and your body puts more resources into your brain power to help you find food. In modern society, that means more energy flow for your neurons, which makes you feel more awake and ready to conquer the day. But that won't last forever. The reason people keep doing it is a mystery. Maybe because we want to believe we have more control over our bodies than we do. Or perhaps we feel like we have to make up for eating badly. Or because we hear about pollution and toxins in our environment, we feel attacked. Or maybe just because taking a pill seems easier than a healthy diet and exercise. Who knows? The best way to detox your body, according to medical science, is not to drink only juice for a week, but rather to eat healthy, go exercise, and go outside. We couldn't have made this episode of D News without support from Harry's. Valentine's Day is just around the corner, y'all, and Harry's is offering a special Winston shave kit that comes with three blades, a personalized chrome razor, and really awesome smelling shaving gel. The kit makes a great V-Day gift, and D Newsers will get 15 bucks off with the coupon code DNewsValentine, all one word. If you want to change how you shave, check out harrys.com and stop paying a ton of money for razors and blades. Do you have friends who do cleanses? What do you tell them? How do you talk to them about it? Do you do a cleanse yourself? Have you ever done a detox? Do you care about the science at all? Go down into the comments, let us know, and subscribe for more D News. If you want to know more about intermittent fasting, check out this episode that I did a while back, and you can learn how it might actually be fairly healthy. Thanks for watching.